Previously on Matt's Macintosh, our brave hero began an intrepid trip through time in order to review vintage Apple products. Our continuation finds him in the year 2000.
So here I am in the year 2000. Now I just knew growing up the year 2000 was going to rock. It seemed so far in the future then. I just knew we'd have flying cars and ray guns and live in space colonies. It was going to be great. What was the year 2000 really like? Well, they had the dot-com bubble bust, Y2K, Britney Spears had the number one album. But Apple released a computer that year that was futuristic. In fact, you could say it was so futuristic, it was like the future cubed.
The G4 Cube is probably most famous for its design. It's shaped like, guess what? A cube. Now for some reason Steve Jobs seemed to have really favored this design. If you look, even when he worked at Next Computers, he also made a cube-shaped PC, which actually went on to become the world's first web server. The machine itself is encased in a clear acrylic, which almost gives the appearance that it's floating. It's only broken up by the fact that it has a hole in the back to allow you to connect your peripherals. Another interesting thing about this machine is that there's no fan inside. It uses a convection-based type cooling, which actually makes it run almost completely silent. The Cube is another example of Steve Jobs' hatred of buttons. The machine contains no physical buttons, only a touch-sensitive pad on the top, and this actually leads to some annoyance with some users since it's easy to accidentally turn on and off your computer. To maintain the aesthetics of the design, they put all the input-out connections on the bottom. It's a pretty standard set, USBs, FireWire. The only thing that really stands out is that in addition to the VGA connector for a monitor, it also has the Apple ADC system. Apple ADC was an older display connector, would actually transmit not only video, but also power to your monitor. Speaking of peripherals, one item that came with the Cube that I really like are these Harman Kardon USB speakers. Something you never saw in Apple's advertisements for the Cube is the giant external power source. It's about a quarter of the size of the computer itself, so it's definitely something you kind of want to keep tucked out of the way. One of my favorite parts of the Cube is this handle mechanism that you use to actually get to the interior components of the computer. This feature makes it one of the more convenient Macintoshes to work with, and it makes it easy if you want to do things like upgrade the RAM or the hard drive and really bring it more up to speed with today's computers.
Despite its unique design, the G4 Cube was actually a complete failure for Apple. They only sold it for about a year before they discontinued it. It really had a bad combination of being overpriced and underpowered for the time. Now despite this, the G4 Cube has enjoyed somewhat of a cult status to this day, and a lot of people use upgraded Cubes as their daily computers. Now what I like to think is that the Cube didn't die then, Apple just went back to the drawing board and reinvented it. I would argue that in many ways, the Mac Mini of today is a spiritual successor of the Cube, and that it's a unique design, small form factor desktop Mac. Now join us next time, guys, where we will go through the year 2002 and take a look at the G4 iMac, the first iMac with a flat panel screen. As always, thanks for watching. See you next time.